Dear students, today I am going to explain the D by Haeckel Onsager equation. Before going to discuss the D by Haeckel Onsager equation, first you have to know the equivalent conductance. Now, what is meant by that equivalent conductance? So, I am going to write the definition of equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance is obtained when gram equivalent mass of solute is dissolved in V centimeter cube of volume of solvent is placed in between two electrodes at unit distance and enough area of cross section. Now this is an equivalent conductance. I am going to explain this equivalent conductance. Dear students, equivalent conductance is obtained when 1 gram equivalent mass of solute. 1 gram equivalent mass of solute. For example, equivalent mass of sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is 58.5. This is an equivalent mass. Gram equivalent mass of sodium chloride is 58.5. This 58.5 gram of solute is dissolved in V centimeter cube of volume. Volume is, so here this is a volume, V is a volume. This is 58.5 gram is dissolved in certain volume of solvent. The total volume, okay, whatever, for example 1 liter, 58.5 gram of sodium chloride is dissolved in 1 liter. Volume is 1 liter. Okay. Now this is placed in between the 2 electrodes. Suppose this is a 2 electrodes, remember this is a 2 electrodes. Okay, 2 electrodes. This total volume, the volume containing 58.5 gram of sodium chloride is placed in between these 2 electrodes at a unit distance. Unit distance means it is 1 meter or 1 centimeter, whatever it may be, but unit distance. So, unit distance, 1 centimeter, you can assume that it's very near, 1 centimeter. Or you can also, if you take a large electrode, it is 1 meter also. Now, in this 1 centimeter, at a unit distance, it is 1 centimeter. I am going to take that. Enough area of cross section. Area of cross section means this is in L by A. Okay, L by A, remember. So this area of A means area of cross section. Area of cross section. So here it is. Enough area means if you increase the area, the unit distance, the two electrodes is there. If you increase the area, no problem. If you take a large platinum sheets, okay. If you increase the area, because whatever the volume you have to take that, the whole volume you have to take that in between the electrode. Suppose you are going to find out the equivalent conductance of this 58.5 gram of sodium chloride dissolved in 1 liter. Total 1 liter is placed in between these two electrodes. Okay, that's why it is required enough area of cross section. Enough area of cross section is there, but it is containing 58.5 gram of sodium chloride. Enough area of cross section. So, in this condition, whatever the conductors obtained, this is called as an equivalent conductance. Exactly you have to take 58.5 gram. For example, if you have taken 2 liter, volume is 2 liter. So, this is not changing, 58.5 gram is not changing because the definition itself, the gram equivalent mass of solute is dissolved in centimeter cube of volume. So, that's why this much of solute is dissolved in V centimeter cube of solvent is placed in between the two electrode unit distance and enough area of cross section. Okay, but in a case of specific conductance, unit distance and unit area of cross sections. Okay, you have taken cube, so conductance obtained in a cube. Volume is also same. It is totally one cube, so you are going to find out the conductance. But it is not like that. In area of cross section is enough. Okay, so this is called as an equivalent conductor. Molar conductance is also the same. So whatever the moles, one mole of solute is dissolving. Okay, one mole of solute is dissolving. Which centimeter cube of volume of solvent is placed in between the two electrodes in a area of cross section and unit distance of two electrodes. Okay, so this is called as a molar conductance. So this is an equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance at any dilution. V centimeter cube means equivalent conductance at any dilution. If you take a large quantity of volume, okay, 10 liter or 20 liter or 100 liters, 58.5 gram is dissolved in 100 liters. Okay. In that cases, you have to take that equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Okay, infinite dilution. So, this is about the equivalent conductance. So, why I am going to write this or explain this equivalent conductance? Because D by F L also an expression is involved the equivalent conductance. Okay. By using D by F L also an equation, you are going to find out the equivalent conductance at any dilution. Now I am going to write the equation of D by FL Onsager equation. Okay. lambda infinity. Okay. Or lambda naught also you have to take that. Minus, so in bracket 82.4 divided by here into T raised to half meter. This is dielectric constant plus 8.2 into 10 raised to 5 divided by dielectric constant into temperature, absolute temperature raised to half, multiplied by this lambda infinity. So, outside the bracket, this is square root of constant rate. Got it? Now, this is the equation. D by FL Onsager equation. So, this, what is meant by this lambda? Lambda is equivalent conductance, at any dilution. Dilution lambda naught, lambda infinity, lambda naught or lambda infinity is equivalent conductance at a infinite dilution. Okay. Next, this is T is an absolute temperature. Now, so this is dielectric constant. And one more, eta is equal to viscosity coefficient, and remaining temperature is over. Okay, all these factors are products of viscosity coefficient of the medium. So this is an equation. Clearly you can observe this viscosity coefficient. Now in this lambda, equivalent conductance at any dimension, V centimeter cube, 1 liter, 2 liter, 3 liter, 4 liter, whatever it may be, okay, you are going to calculate. And then lambda infinity is a constant value. For example, sodium chloride, equivalent conductance at infinite dilution is 124.5. Okay, so this is a conductance, 124.5, this is, and it's a common value and it is a constant value. It will not change it because the infinite dilution, 58.5 gram of solute is dissolved in enough solvent. Okay, infinite dilution, more than 100, enough area of cross section is also there. So that's why equivalent conductance at infinite dilution of a particular solute, it is a constant. Same way the HL constant value is also there, and also you have to take experience of KCl. All these solutes having a constant value of equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. T is an absolute temperature. You have to take that absolute temperature. And this is the dielectric constant of the solvent. This is very important. When that high dielectric constant, the dissolution is more in polar solvent. Okay. For example, sodium chloride is readily soluble in water because of the water having a high dielectric constant. Same way, viscosity of the medium, because it is also affect the solvent property, so viscosity of the medium or viscosity coefficient of the medium is also important. If the viscosity is more, okay, the solubility is decreasing. And the movement of the ion is also decreasing because the liquid is more viscous. Okay, the viscous drag is happening. I will tell later what is meant by the viscous drag. Okay, so that's why here if the viscosity is more, okay, now the equivalent conductance value is decreasing. So this is an equation and all these terminologies, okay, abbreviations for this terminologies. This is a 2-mark question, will be asked in the examination. Okay. This is about the D/L on Fraga equation. Next I am going to explain the relaxation effect. Okay. What is meant by that relaxation effect? Relaxation effect. relaxation effect. It is also called as an asymmetric effect. Okay, asymmetric effect. Now, what is meant by this relaxation effect? In the postulate of Biba-Hackel theory of strong electrolyte, we already know about the solvent. If you take a solvent and if you take a solute, the solute is dissolved in a solvent, particular solvent. Now ionization is happening and it is dissolved to a formation of ions. Then each ion is surrounded by oppositely charged ions. Now it will create an ionic atmosphere or sphere is created. How that this sphere is created? Because here the positive charges is there. For example, ions are formed. Now positive charges is surrounded by negative charges. Positive charges is surrounded by negative charges. Now, after passing a current, electric current, okay, here there is a two electrode, remember. Two electrode. This is a positive electrode, this is a negative electrode. Negatively charged electrodes. After passing the electricity in between the two electrodes, automatically this sphere is destroyed. It means here this is centrally positively charged. This central positive charge ion is moved towards the negatively charged electrodes. Again, this negatively charged ions is moved towards the positively charged electrodes. It's a simple phenomenon. Now, automatically this sphere, hydration sphere or the solvation sphere, this is also called as a solvation sphere. Okay. This sphere is destroyed. Ionic atmosphere or ionic sphere is destroyed. Okay. Now, after this, okay, switch off this current, okay, you can cut off this whatever electricity, okay, disconnect this electricity. Again, it re-establishes. It will take a certain time. So after this destroying this whatever this ionic sphere, okay, again it is re-established after disconnecting electricity. Okay, so it will take a time. That is called as a relaxation time or relaxation effect. Here again it is formed. So these ions are moved in this direction. This positive ion moved in this direction. So after disconnecting the electricity, again it is formed. Again it is formed. Now this is an asymmetric effect. Asymmetric effect. Now this is a symmetry. Here the time taken for asymmetric to symmetric type ionic sphere, it is called as a relaxation type or relaxation effect. Now the time gap between the asymmetric and symmetric formation of this ionic sphere, it is called as a relaxation effect, or is also called as an asymmetric effect. Okay. Now this is about the relaxation effect. Next, one more concept I am going to explain: electrophoric effect. Electrophoretic effect. It's very simple. You already know about this electrophoretic effect. Electrophoretic effect means the ionic atmosphere or ionic sphere in between the two electrodes. Okay, this is a symmetric one. Now after passing this, this is positive, this is negative electrodes. After passing the current, okay, or electricity, what happens? This negatively charged ions is moved toward the positively charged electrode. Positively charged ions move toward the negatively charged electrodes. So this is called as a electrophoretic effect. This is also happening. So when you pass the current in between the two electrodes, this is called as an electrophoretic effect. Next I am going to explain the viscous drag. So what is meant by a viscous drag? Depend upon the viscosity. If every solvent having a certain viscosity. Now what happens if the solvent having high viscosity, now this will resist the movement of the ions. For example, here is a positive and negative ion is there. Okay. Now this is placed in a solvent molecules. So this is solvent having a high viscosity. Now this is this positive ion is moved towards in this direction, negative ion is moved towards this direction after passing the current. If the viscosity is more, what happens? That will reduce the movement of the ions. Automatically the conductance is also decreases. The viscous drag is more. Okay, the viscous drag is more. The conductivity is decreasing and also that ionization or dissociation is also decreasing because of it is more viscous. The opposite force or viscous force acting again at this the movement of this ions. Okay, so this is called as a viscous drag. These three terminology is very very important point of your examination also. One is there is relaxation effect. Relaxation effect means time gap or time taken for asymmetric to symmetric formation of the ionic sphere. And electrophoretic effect means the movement of the ions towards the particular electrode, positively charged electrodes. It's called as an electrophoretic effect. And viscous drag is so that is every solvent having a viscosity, so that will create an opposing force against the movement of the ion. It is a viscous drag.